Hey guys, Amy here. Today I am going to be cutting down the cranberry hibiscus that we have over here behind in the corner. When we planted it this spring, these banana trees were only not even knee high. Obviously they've taken over and my cranberries are not getting the sunlight that they should. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take the plant out completely. I'm going to go ahead and harvest as much leaves as I can, and then we're going to also propagate to where we can grow these elsewhere, mainly along the fence lines where we know that they'll thrive and be better. So I got myself my good scissors, gloves, and then I have a bucket, a little 5-gallon bucket here full of some water so I can cut and put them into water. And then what I'll do then is after I get done taking care of this, I'll probably take everything inside and then sit on the floor and divide out my leaves and the stems. So let's get going with this cranberry hibiscus. All right, guys, there's where I had the two. They were completely covering, my banana trees were completely covering everything. I put them on the ground. I did sort of the chop and drop because that's what we kind of do. So hopefully here after the winter, we will be able to go ahead and plant something else or put an ice cream banana there. But my bucket is full. I did not realize how big one of them had gotten, and it was actually crowding out the other one. So, all right, off to harvest now. Okay, guys, I finally got it up on the deck. This is going to be way too big to take into my house. I mean, I'm 5'2", and let me turn myself around here. And this thing is literally up to my spider, sorry, but I'm standing with the bucket and literally some of these are just too huge, you know, size comparison. I'm maybe only 5'2". It's getting hot, even though it's October in Central Florida. It's supposed to get up to 92 today, so I wanted to get this done before the heat was really on. But a few things about this. The cranberry hibiscus is also called Florida hibiscus. It's also called false arrest. There is the red version, which is this, and there's a green version. Now, the green version, if you look here, you could tell it kind of looks like a cannabis leaf. The green one is called false arrest because people will report their neighbors for growing marijuana, and turns out it's actually a hibiscus. They bloom red flowers. Here's another good shot of them. Little one there. Now, you can eat these straight off the plant. We use them in tacos, hamburgers. We also are going to try, I'm going to take some of these and see if I can dry the leaves and then mash it up into a fine powder. That way we can sprinkle it on. They're really good. They have a a citrus taste. They're not spicy at all. They're more citrusy than anything else. And let me see if I can pull one off here. Normally the younger ones are better. Let me turn you around. That way y'all can see me, but they're really good. You don't have to eat the stems. So even if you pick it off, you can eat the whole leaf. They're really easy to propagate. Pretty much what we do is we actually will cut them, trim off the bottom leaves, leave just a few on top, mainly the baby leaves. And then we stick them in water for roughly 2 weeks. We wait until we can see roots growing. And then you look over here, we then stick them in pots. And then we let them grow in the pots for a few weeks. All we do is water them, and then we can plant them. They are really super easy to grow, guys. It's unreal. And now, one thing you want to know is if you do decide to get some and grow some, see how these are kind of greenish looking? Greenish brown, in a way. This was the one I cut down in the back. When the red hibiscus does not get enough sunlight, they will stay like this dull greenish brownish color. They love full sun. When they're in full sun, they're this beautiful dark red on top and then a lighter red on the bottom, as you can tell, the bottom side. I have one over here by my ditch. See if I can zoom in on it. And that one has died and come back twice. We did not pull it out of the ground. The first time it flooded so bad, the roots got waterlogged and everything died. So we cut it down to the ground. It came back the next season. And then in the winter of 2017, we had that hard freeze. It killed it. Even though we draped it and covered it, it still died. And then the spring, it came right back. So it's a pretty hardy plant, as long as you take care of it. That's the one we use when we're cooking. And then hopefully here we will take these guys. And like I said, we're going to save a bunch of them. I'm going to plant some along the fence line where my ducks and chickens are to help with some shade. And also too, if any leaves go into the flock's pen, they can enjoy a little treat too. I'm going to plant it close, but not close enough. So that way, even if they eat the backside, we still got the front side that looks good. but yeah, if you guys are able to, they are hardy up to zone 8. I would recommend if you're in zones 8 or above, maybe putting them in pots, and you can control the pots. I mean, you can keep them little. You may have to go, you know, get a bigger pot every now and then, but I would put them in pots and just either keep them in your greenhouse or keep them on a sunny windowsill if you have one, you know, inside the house for the colder areas. Hey guys. All right, day 2 of trying to harvest this cranberry hibiscus. I let them sit overnight because I got caught up with doing regular house stuff. Today I'm getting a late start, so I'm hoping I won't spend too much time in the sun, but I'm going to go ahead and show y'all exactly how I do this. There's the plant. I'm going to put the leaves on the blanket here. I got my scissors. And I'm going to do a couple different things. One is I'm going to harvest the leaves, and we are going to take some of them and put them in the freezer. We're going to keep some to use for our dinners and whatnot. And then I'm going to dry some of them and see if I can crush them into a powder. And then that way we'll have we'll have it a couple different ways. I'm not quite sure about freezing lettuce or these leaves. kind of iffy on it. I'm only going to keep the ones that are good, like the ones that look like this. I'm going to more than likely give to my ducks and my chickens and my guineas. I'm going to try and keep the ones that are pretty good. And then the stems, some of the longer ones I'm going to cut, but we're going to propagate these. I'm going to leave them in this 5-gallon bucket to grow their roots. And then we will transplant them into soil pots, which you can see over there. I got a whole bucket stack of them. And then we got some going over here. Sorry, the sun's in full force. Those will be planting here probably by this weekend. So with all that set, I'm going to go ahead and sit down on the porch here and get some stuff started so that way I can get this done. Hopefully it won't get too hot today. Alright guys, here's what I have. Oh, let me turn on another light here. Get a little bit of better perspective. Okay. Out of that 5-gallon bucket, that's what I got for chicken waste. That's my compost. And then, let me show you these. I got one vase. Two vases, that one's really tall. It's just so thick I could not cut it with the scissors. I had to get choppers. And then vase number 3. These are all going to be cuttings. Hopefully you start new bushes. Hopefully we'll be able to sell some. And all in all, the injury I got was I got a blister on my pinky from doing the scissors. And then here is, I just try to keep the cats out of the leaves because the cats like leaves. Literally a box half full of leaves. I still have to go through all of these, trim off the ends because I was in the heat. So I was in a hurry. So I still got to go through these leaves by tonight because I want to get them in the fridge or in the freezer. And then some of them I want to start drying in paper bags, but there's a cool looking one. Oh, here's another one. So, once I get officially done, I'll show you guys the bags and everything, but for right now, that's where I'm at. It took me more than right around 6 hours. I sat down and ate lunch with my daughter, but almost 6 hours of sitting out in the sun, and it was kind of hot today, about 92, but the humidity wasn't too bad. So that's about it, and I'll show you the end results here soon, guys. Alright, if you like that video, give us a thumbs up, like, and subscribe. We also are on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And we also have a Facebook group where you can post your own pictures and also make comments and help other people grow something for your family.